Did you know that Google is rewriting your ads? I'm going to tell you how they're doing that, how to stop them, and whether you should stop them. Hey, this is John Horn from Stub Group. We are a top premier Google partner digital advertising agency, and we help businesses dominate Google ads and make money online. And I'm going to explain to you something called automated assets. Basically, this is a way that Google adds information that you yourself did not write to your ads. Now, this can be a good thing, but it can also be a bad thing. And so I'm going to tell you exactly how this works. So first of all, when Google says asset, they're talking about a piece of information that's added to your ad. It could be a piece of text, it could be an image, it could be an address from your Google My Business location. And these are all things that you can generally manually create yourself in your Google Ads account. For example, you can create site links that link to other pages on your website and that appear as links beneath your regular text ads. You can add callouts, which are additional pieces of text that you can add to your ad. You can add location assets, which link your Google My Business profile to your ad, so forth and so on. And Google highly recommends you do this, as do I. Adding these things helps make your ad larger, gives people more opportunities to engage with your ad, and ultimately helps increase your ad rank, which makes it more likely that Google will show your ad. Now, Google recommends that you use assets to such an extent that they actually sometimes will do it for you. And that's where these automated assets come in. So there are some settings which frankly are fairly hidden in your Google Ads account that give Google the permission to do this. And these are settings that you can turn on and off. So when I say that Google is secretly doing this, I'm not saying that they're necessarily trying to do something underhanded and do something without telling you. But the reality is most advertisers don't know this is happening. And hey, even most agencies don't know this is happening because these settings are fairly well hidden or hard to navigate to in the Google Ads interface. So I'm going to share my screen with you and show you exactly where to go to control these and what each one means, as well as whether or not any of these are good things that you should keep turned on. So when you're in your Google Ads account, you're going to navigate to the Ads and Assets area and then go to Assets. And this will tell you information about what you have added in your account. And one thing you can do too is Google has this column called Source. So if you see something that says automatically created as a source, that means that Google created that for you, that you didn't manually create that within the account. So that's a good tip off as to whether or not you're actually using these automated extensions right now. So when you're in the Assets area, there's going to be a little button that says More with three vertical dots. You can click on that and it takes you or gives you the option that says Account Level Automated Assets. Click on that and then it'll give you some more information, but you're actually not yet where you need to go. You need to click on that same More button again, and this time it'll say Advanced Settings. Click on that, and now you have access to control whether or not Google can use these different automated assets. So let's talk through each one of these and whether or not it's good to use. Dynamic site links. A site link is a link to another page on your website. Typically, Google will display at least four of these when they end up showing these site links, and they appear under your ad. So you have your main landing page that people will get to if they click on your ad, and then you might have something like a store page, contact us, things like that that show up as additional links below your ad. Now, using site links is a great idea. I recommend that pretty much everybody do it. But I have seen with these automated site links that Google will select pages that, frankly, I don't want to send people to when they're engaging with our ads. I've seen them pick like our blog page or pages that are not well optimized to convert. And I don't want to pay to send traffic to those pages. I want to pay to send traffic to my landing pages and other pages on the website that I know are valuable and people likely won't bounce away from. So generally, there's always nuances here, but generally I'd say turn off dynamic site links, which is an automated asset in your Google Ads account. Next up, we have dynamic callouts. Now, callout is a piece of text that you can add to your ad. It could be a credibility element. We've been in business for 25 years. It could be 50% off. It could be whatever. You can type whatever you want in there, essentially, but it's additional text. And again, I've seen Google do some funky things here and add pieces of information that were frankly like invalid or that add no additional value add to the ad copy. And this is especially concerning in more sensitive areas like healthcare, legal, places where you have to sign off on what ad copy you put out there. Google could actually get you into legal water by putting something in your ad that you did not know was there and should not have been there. So generally, I'll turn off dynamic callouts as well. Similar thing for dynamic structured snippets. Again, this is additional text that Google can add. It's formatted in a particular way. It's usually a list of things like types of products, types of categories, amenities you have at your hotel, things like that. But again, Google can come up, I've seen them come up with some pretty weird things here, so I recommend keeping this turned off. Now, seller ratings is something that I would pretty much always recommend turning on. This gives Google the option to show gold stars in your ads if you are using a Google-approved seller rating service and you've collected a certain number of reviews with a high enough aggregate review rating. This is something that's great. Love to see it. And it's also not Google just making things up. It's Google just pulling information that's on the web into your ad. So generally, I'd say leave this on. Longer ad headlines is an option that I would also generally leave on. And this is, again, not Google writing new information. It's simply giving Google the ability to add description to your headline or add your domain name to your headline, which makes your ad bigger and more likely to be engaged with. And that's cool. Bigger is better, generally, and it's not Google making up text on their own. Automated apps is something that's not relevant for most advertisers. Essentially, it's if you have an app, then it helps people engage with that and get to the location in your app where they want to reach. For most businesses, again, they don't have an app, so it really doesn't matter. If you have an app, cool, you know, keep it turned on. Even if you don't have an app, turning it on is not a problem. It's kind of a moot point for 95% of advertisers. Now, automated locations is an interesting one. Essentially, it's Google looking out there to see if you have a Google My Business location for your business that's not already linked to your Google Ads account. Now, in most cases, if you have a Google My Business location, you want to link that to your ad account because it gives Google more information to work with about people who are geographically located close to you. It helps Google add information from your GMB listing to your ad, which can help boost ad performance. So generally, I would say it's good to use. I have seen it backfire from time to time when Google got it wrong and actually found a location that did not belong to a client and entered it into their ad copy. So in that situation, we definitely turned it off. So this one, sometimes okay, sometimes not okay. Play it by ear. And then dynamic images, this is another one where Google is saying, hey, we can take pictures from your landing page and use them as image assets in your text ads. Generally, I'm okay with this because generally I'm okay with the images that would be on our website or specifically a landing page appearing with the ad copy. But again, it can be a little tricky. So Google can, you know, pick something that maybe doesn't look good or make sense and use that as an image. So this one, sometimes yes, sometimes no, a little more of a case-by-case basis, but something to be aware of. So long story short, again, be aware of these automated assets, know what's turned on and what's turned off in your account, and make sure that you are displaying the ad experience and messaging to people that you think you are showing to them.
Hey, do you want to dominate Google Ads and grow your business? Subscribe to this channel and we'll help you learn how. You see, we've made almost $500 million for our clients from Google Ads. In fact, according to Google, Stub Group is one of the best performing Google partners in the world. Subscribe to our channel for more videos like the one you just watched and learn how to dominate Google Ads, increase profits, and grow your business too. And check out the description below for your own free Google Ads profit plan, customized for your business. Thanks.